Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stealwing 33 Plays Dark Souls 2. I'm Stealwing 33, and today, ladies and gentlemen, I have a confession to make. I died between episodes. I went to go check out the boss weapon shop where with Ornifex and or whatever the hell her name is, the bird lady who makes boss weapons, and I fell into the sand pit on accident, and it killed me, and I died. So there you go. My bad. I didn't mean to die, but I died. So, you know, now we're here. So we're just gonna try to make our way down into the sand pit. I hope the quality's good. We're running at a good old fashioned 60 FPS finally. I changed the recording settings in my OBS to run off of my graphics card instead of my processor. Because my processor sucks, apparently. Well, it doesn't suck. That's not fair. It's a good processor. It just can't handle playing things like Dark Souls 2 and Overwatch and stuff while recording. It does fine with one or the other, but it doesn't do fine with both. So, it's bad, but my graphics card is pretty good. You know, we're doing fine. Well, I mean, we'll see. The recordings look fine. I've done pretty extensive testing, but, you know, I won't know until... a lot of it's going to come down to file size, because the new settings I have increase the file size of my recordings, like, dramatically. And not just, like, a little bit. Like, they went from, like, maybe hitting 4 or 5 gigabytes on, like, some of my, like, hour-long files to, like... hitting that in like maybe 10-20 minutes. So, you know, not that you guys care too much about the technical details, but you know, it's if you're interested in what it is to, like, you know, record and what it takes to actually do these things, like, you know, I talked about it a little bit in one of the Overwatch episodes I did with Tony earlier this week. But it's a bad time. Now, I'm not going to put any Pharos Lockstones in at all while we're down here. I know a lot of these are used during the Royal Rat Authority Covenant in order to activate traps. If I want to do anything with Pharos Lockstones, I'm probably going to have to look up a guide for it. Like, I think this one, like, if I activate this, it, like, pushes me into the water or something like that and I die. So we need to be cautious about how we get around down here. The less of those things we activate without knowing what they do, the better. So, you know, there you go. Now this is where I remember the Royal Rat Authority fight coming in. I remember there being a boss fight that's just a bunch of rats, basically. In fact, I think I can see, like, a bunch of rats over there. What up, nerds? I'm not sure why they're, like, they're just chilling out back there. Oh, no, here they come. Die. 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 Easy peasy. I think that's where we come out of the Royal Rat Authority fight. I thought that was the name of this. Maybe this is just, like, the Rat Authority or something. I don't know. I have a rat tail, so there's a chance that I might not have to, like, actually do this. Yeah, so I think, like, that's... like, you think you put the Pharos Lockstone in there to get the bridge, and I think it pushes you into the water or something. This is like a poison vat. You'd activate that Pharos Lockstone that will activate the poison or something. All I remember is that this entire area is full of horseshit. Like, straight up just the worst area in the game. Because you're supposed to invade people here, right? Like, I can't use the bonfire? What? I mean, alright, I'll just... fuck it. I don't know how easy it's going to be for us to kill rats with a stabbing implement, but, you know, I've been having an okay time so far, so maybe it'll be fine. See, like, I remember this is like a boss fight, right? Or is this just like an area? I thought this was a boss fight, but, you know, I've been wrong before. Oh, fucking petrify, that's not good. Need to not get petrified. Petrification will turn me into stone and kill me instantly. Which means that, like, the, like, pathetic amount of damage that these rats do is actually going to become problematic if I get hit too many times. and especially if I get hit too quickly. So we just gotta be cautious. This fight's not hard, they're just rats. And then I think there's, like, a big rat that spawns in later that we have to, like, deal with, if I remember correctly. Turns out the rapier is actually pretty good at dealing with rats. Who'd have thought? Normally I used a broadsword during all this. Royal Rat Vanguard. That's the boss fight, apparently. I need to get rid of all these rats before... Well, I need to find the big rat. Where's the big one? Or the one that I'm supposed to kill, rather. Is it you? Are you the rat I'm supposed to kill? Yeah, the one with the mohawk. That's bad. The petrification resistance is, probably a big one on this one. Drink, you bastard. Drink! Gotta counteract the poison. Quick, run away. Run away from the rats. Gotta drink again. I have to survive the poison before I can go back to fighting again, because I don't want to get bit, and I need to wait for the petrification to wear off, which both things are important. The petrification is probably more important to worry about than the other one. There we go. All the rats are dead now. There you go. Dead, you hear me? Dead! Now, bloody fucking rats, get out of here. Royal Rat Vanguard Soul is mine, and I got a rat tail as well, which means I can talk to the Rat King over here. What up, Rat King?
Thou return. I am not unkind. Shouldst thou forbear thy way, swearest thou?
Nope.
Then we need consort no longer.
Alright, talk to you later, rat guy. That's a big, that's a big statue, a coffin guy. Skeleton! Hurrah for skeleton! Why is he chained inside the box? It's weird. Alright, there we go. And I didn't fall through the hole, which I feel like I was supposed to. Good luck. Make a jump. Alright, I can do that. Fast food feels cozy. Yeah, so, I mean, that fight's not hard. That was pretty easy. I don't know, I fought harder things in, like, earlier in the game than that Royal Rat Authority fight. I know it's not the Royal Rat Authority. I keep calling it that because it's, like, the Royal Rat Vanguard fight. We fought the Royal Rat Authority earlier as the big doggo. That's a bleedstone. Alright, not bad. Not bad at all. Hurrah for Reckless. Alright, let's do this. We can make this jump, right? Let's put on the cat ring so that there's like a minuscule chance that if I miss this, I'll survive the fall all the way down there. I mean, I'm gonna die to like the exploding fart guys anyway, but you know, it's worth a shot, right? Worst case scenario, I don't live and I end up having to drag my ass all the way back down here. I fucking missed. Well, I fucking survived. Alright, die. Die. Okay, cool, cool. Easy does it. Stay calm. I just need to, like, be able to see them before they, like, get on top of me, and then we'll be fine. Got him. Cool. Rapier really coming in handy right now. Really coming in handy. Fantastic. All right. Easy. That was a lot easier when I tried not to, like, just dodge roll the shit out of them. That must have been really frustrating last episode. I'm real sorry about that. I apparently forgot how to play video games. Great heal. It's a great spell. If you're doing a miracle build, which, by the way, I have decided that after I'm finished with Dark Souls 1, or Dark Souls 2 and all of its DLC, I'm going to play 1, but we're going to go back to, I'm going to do a miracle build and use, like, the Great Sword of Astoria and stuff. And we're going to try to use some magic and get into some stuff. But, I think as a handicap, I am going to use a fat man build, which means I won't be able to roll. Like, I'm just going to wear really heavy armor and use a really powerful shield. And that's going to be, like, the deciding factor there, is that I won't be able to roll at all. Which I will inevitably forget and end up getting, like, punked out super hard because of it. And, you know, hopefully that'll make it entertaining for you guys to watch me get my shit kicked in over and over again as I forget to roll over and over again for some reason. You know, if that's not, doesn't sound interesting to you, please let me know, like, now, before I start doing it. You know, if you guys would prefer to, like, great swords are not something that I commonly use. So I'm not good with the moveset for great swords, and they're very slow. And Dark Souls is the only game I've ever, like, the only RPG I've ever played where playing, like, a great shield character, like, high strength, really slow character, wasn't appealing for me. I've always played really fast mobile characters in this game. So, you know, it will have its foibles for me, which, you know, you guys might enjoy watching. I don't know. I don't know why you guys watch, like watching me in general. I mean, Only person I know that likes watching me is Scoblin. Seems to enjoy my witty antics and my analyses of... Ow! Alright. You spitting shit over there. Fucking jerkbag. Woo! Ow! 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 Stop it! Ow, stop it! Come on now. Spitting's not nice. Ugh, I wish I had a torch. I know I can use a flame butterfly to, like, spark up a torch. I just wish I had one already. Ow. Okay, well, there's a bonfire. Drink, drink, drink. No, 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 no. Oh, I died. Well, hopefully lighting the bonfire counts, I guess. I guess I kicked the bucket from poison. First time for everything, right, guys? First time for everything. I'm hoping that the increased bit rate's actually making the game come in clearer. It hasn't been, like, bad in Dark Souls 2. It was bad in Overwatch, but it's not been bad in Dark Souls 2. But the lag was what was really making me have to change stuff, because, you know, it was, when I was playing, like, higher fidelity games, like, you guys probably saw it a little bit in 3, like, we got some really bad slowdown in 3. Every now and then, like, it was never, like, crippling. Like, it was sort of the kind of thing that I, like, could get away with ignoring, and so I did for a while, but playing Overwatch and having it, like, not only play like garbage, but kind of look like garbage, like, I don't know, I got upset, decided to do something about it. That was a fucking bear, man. It's a fucking bear skeleton, man. Oh, hey! Sticky buddy, how's it going? He's trying to sneak up on me. Did you guys see that? He was like, I'm gonna get him all snakey-bakey, like, wow. That's good. Yeah. I'm sorry if my upload schedule gets a little erratic, by the way. You know, I try to do my best to stay to... I try to produce a minimum of, you know, 10 or... Like, not 10. Try to produce a minimum of 5 videos a week. I've been taking the weekends off because they're the only time that I have to myself most of the time. But I started a new job at the summer camp that I worked at last year. And, the problem is that my job's a lot more strenuous this time. It's not like... So last year... Dark Pyromancy Flame. Cool. Last year, I mostly just did IT support, right? So I sat around and did nothing, and then did IT support when people needed, like, you know, something to get fixed. I fucking hate this area, because it's impossible to see in here. But then, like, if it's not impossible to see, it's like... it's like a maze, so it's like there's a lot of up and down and stuff, which, you know, has its place, but that place does not necessarily need to be right now. That torch is super bright, by the way. Like, super bright. Holy crap, that is like... That's like turning on the fucking sun! Yeah, goddamn. Right, let's make this jump. Oh! Fantastic, alright. I guess we'll set light to a couple of these things while I have my torch out. Wow, I never noticed the walls move in here. That's fucking creepy. I am uncomfortable with that. That is... It's not cool. That hurt my... That didn't hurt my thing very much. Okay, that's good. That is good, yeah? Alright, set light to this, and I guess we'll climb that and see where that goes. It seems to be going where I need to go. Or at least it's going to that fog gate, which I'm assuming is where I need to go? I don't know, man. I don't believe you, but I don't know enough about fog gates to dispute it. Tons of these, like, fucking poison statue things all over the place. Highly uncomfortable. Saw one of them spit at me, and I don't know which one it was, so I'm just gonna break all of them. It's always my answer for everything. What's that? I don't know where the attack came from. Just destroy everything. It'll be fine. It's fine. It's fine. Alright, I'm gonna fall in that hole. Nope, I didn't fall in the hole. Alright, we gotta figure out how to get there. I think that's where I need to go, where, like, that those, like, sides of beef are. At least I hope they're beef. They look like beef. Where's the beef? Oh my god, so my favorite meme ever is the, I smell like beef kid. Yeah, you guys ever heard of this meme? It's like this kid, it's this little kid, and he's like sitting in front of the camera, and he just looks at the camera and goes, I smell like beef. I smell like beef. And he just, like, just says, I smell like beef over and over again. And, like, I don't know why I think it's the funniest thing ever, but it's the funniest thing ever. That's the bonfire over there. Okay. If I light these things as I go, it should be easier for me to, like, know where I've been and where I haven't been. Which will be nice. Is it this way? Message ahead. Oh, shit! Well, distracted me, you fucking jerk. Visions of pincer attack. Well, I see you up there. Walking around like a T-Rex. Alright, well, I killed one, so I guess I'll... I gotta pay closer attention to the sound in the game. Because the sound is very important to hear people walking around near me. Stab, 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 stab. Ow, I'm poisoned. Drink. Open the menu. Do I have any more recovery items that get rid of poison? Does not appear so. I mean, I have the divine blessings, but I'm not willing to eat those to get rid of. Oh, I can use this. All right, cool. All right, and then what does this do? Is this poison resist? Yes, it is. All right, eat that. Here's a little bit of poison resistance here while I round this corner and stab, stab. Aha, take that. All right, we're doing fine. This area is stupid, and I don't like it, but like, we're doing fine regardless of that, I guess. If you want to like look at it that way, I suppose. Fast food feels scuzzy. All right, roll, break, break. I'm like worried I'm gonna like break my fucking rapier on like these pots and shit. The reason I'm lighting all of these things, by the way, if you're wondering why I'm wasting my time lighting all of these stupid little things, is they let me know where I've been and they let me know where I need to go. So like, you know, now I know that like I've been here. Like I've been to here. I want to go to there. But I've been to here. I fell on a fucking doggo. Fucking bear doggo. Oh, ow. Oop. Well, fine. You're dead now. Cool. And then, am I near the fog gate? Did that fall fucking screw me out of getting my fog gate? Doesn't look like it. I mean, why would I want to go over there? That seems like a bad idea. Is there an item over here? Nope, just bloodstains. Fantastic. Bonfire ahead. You know, I don't believe you, but I'm gonna go ahead and just choose to like come this way anyway. We're gonna drink, because I'm poisoned. All of these things appear to be poisoned, so we're gonna break all of them. All right, bonfire. There's a bonfire ahead. That guy didn't lie. All right, fair enough. Dick. Drink this before I keel over here. That. All right. Yeah, they look like sides of beef. Don't they? Like they look like beef. They look like beef. Alright. Light that on fire. Give myself a little bit of light. I've got an hour worth of torch left, so I'm not too concerned about, you know, anything like that. Break that. Fantastic. Fantastic, Mr. Bombastic. I just come through this mist. What's over here? Doggo. I guess it's a bear. Like, I don't know. These things are like, in Dark Souls 1, they're skeletons. In this one, they're fucking meat things for some reason. I'm uncomfortable with all the poison in this area. I think that over there is like the wretched one or something. Like, I don't remember this boss's name. But I remember there being a boss in this area that was like, looked like he was made out of meat. And I remember him being very scary. What the fuck is that? I don't know what this is. I'm terrified of it, but I don't know what it is, so I'm just gonna stab the shit out of it. Can I talk to it? Are you friendly? No, you don't seem to be unfriendly, but you don't seem to be friendly either. Just stab it. Just stab the shit out of it. Fuck it. Just kill it. I don't know what it is. If it's important, I'm sure somebody will yell at me for killing it. I got poison moss. Cool, I guess. Poison moss. More poison moss is not... You know what? I'm not going to turn down the free fucking poison moss. I'll tell you that for free. Where the fuck am I supposed to go? I have no idea where I am right now. Am I supposed to go down? Ow! Fucking goddamn it. Alright, let's go down. They make me put my torch away so it's impossible for me to fucking see where I'm going here. Alright. Alright, let's go this way, I guess. There's an item down here. Nope. I feel like I should put on the silver cat ring again, because I feel like this is the kind of area where, like, screwing up my footing will make me plummet to my doom. And I'm not super about plummeting to my doom. Oh, well, yeah, see, if I had the silver cat ring on, I might have survived that. But I didn't. Because I'm dumb. That's right. We'll put it back on and then we'll just press onward. That's alright. I'm hoping I just want to get to a boss. And then a bonfire after a boss. And then we'll be fine. I guess we'll just take off the Ring of Blades again. Put the Silver Cat one back on. Let's light a torch here. Nope. I want to light torch. Oh yeah, that's right. I don't know how to light torches. Y'all need to come at me, yo. I'm the thuggest man to ever spit a rhyme, yo. Bark, bark. Oh fucking shit. I should have just taken the fucking ladder. Alright, that was pretty bad. That was pretty bad. You know, normally I'm much more eloquent than this. I'm just exceptionally dumb today. I'm pretty tired. I like got off work maybe an hour ago. It's like 7 o'clock right now. I got up at 6 a.m. today to go to work. I'm really tired. Like, don't get me wrong, like, I'm not a stranger, I'm not shy around work, like, work's fine. It's just the fucking, like, it's an hour commute there and back. And then, like, I have to, like, my work for the last, like, 3 days has been all, like, entirely composed of fucking manual labor. And, like, I don't normally, like, I'm not, like, one of those people that's like, oh, I'm too good for manual labor, but, like, I got hired to be, like, an administrator, and, like, I had to, like, lift tables and, like, move boxes around all day, and, like, it's just, I'm just tired, like, you know, I know it's, like, it's not one of those things that, like, people give a shit about, like, oh, you did manual labor, boo-hoo, fucking cry about it more, baby pants, but, like, you know, I don't normally, I work in IT normally, right? Like, I'm sitting here and I'm playing goddamn video games for the internet. Like, I don't normally have to do heavy lifting. That is not something I typically must do. But, like, I had to do a lot of it over the last couple days. So I'm pretty tired. Like, and, like, it's been, like, 4 days of, like, waking up at 6 a.m. to go to this camp and lift a ton of objects all day, every day. So I'm like, I just pooped. Like, it just took a lot out of me. Alright, so, I do know something special about this area from when I did it the first time. First things first, do I have poison bite ring? No, I only have curse bite. Curse bite and then I guess, like, the ashen knuckle ring. Do I have anything that increases poison resistance? No? Alright. So, something I do know about this area. Okay, so all of these statues are assholes. Like, universally. So I'm just gonna, like, try to roll past them and get past them without getting poisoned. At least, without getting too poisoned, I guess, is the better way to put it. But, like, the best strategy is to fucking break all the things, right? That's, like, the best strategy. So then we're gonna eat one of these things. Eat a bunch of pieces and all that jazz. But the thing we gotta remember is that there's also a bunch of assholes in this area that we need to worry about. You're not trapped, are you? No, you're good. Cool. Shottle and great magic weapon. The shottle's a good weapon. If you are unfamiliar. These things are assholes. At least they were when I played through it. They apparently are big-ass pushovers right now. Because when I played through it, these things are resistant to blunt. But they apparently are not resistant to piercing. So I could stab the shit out of them without having to worry about it too much. But these things, like, I remember this area being a lot worse than it is. It's clearly, like, just was a matter of my build was bad and I should have felt bad. Ooh, I'm on top of its head. Stab. There we go. Yeah, this area's a lot easier when you're actually, like, dealing good damage to the bad guys. Stab, 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 stab. Dead again. Dead again's good. It makes all the corpses explode around you, which has uses. I don't like it. I don't like having to rely on, like, getting kills to get kills. Like, ow. I'd have never gotten grabbed by one of those before. Let's get away from it for a second. Because I need to find where it is that I need to go for the bonfire that's closer to the boss fight, so I don't have to do that area over and over again. I think it's over here. Yeah, it's over here. Alright, cool. Yeah, so there's, like, this little secret path. You guys saw, like, so there's the rib cage, there's the skull. It's, like, opposite the skull by the glowing statue. Come around this corner, and there's a bonfire over here. It's a lot closer to the boss fight. Highly recommend using it if you're playing through Dark Souls for the first time. Well, Dark Souls 2 for the first time. I know that this is a lot less, like, good. Like, these tips and these tricks are a lot less useful than, like, the ones I gave for, like, Dark Souls 3. But, you know, bear with me on that, because, like, I don't know. I feel like that's the best way to really do these series, is to, like, you know, level with the audience and try to give them some help if they're playing through it. And if they're not playing through it, then, like, you know, fuck them. Like, whatever. Right, I got the Divine Blessing, despite the fact that this guy smashed that fucking thing. I need to drink this. And I kind of want to summon help for this boss fight, but I haven't quite decided if I want to do that or not yet. I appear to have gotten rid of the poison a lot faster than I did last time. I think this is this Pate? Lone Hunter Schmidt! He's got a bow and arrow. And what appears to be, like, some kind of dagger. Yeah, fuck it. Let's summon this guy. Again, I do this not because I need it, but because I think it makes it slightly more entertaining to do the boss fights when I summon the NPC help, because the NPCs are kind of silly billies. I should probably wait for the poison to go away before entering the boss door, huh? I mean, just maybe. If I remember correctly, I can't remember the name of this boss. But I remember he's a huge asshole. I think he's, like, the Wretched, or, like, the Devoured or something stupid. He's got, like, one of those, like, Dark Souls. He's got a Dark Souls name, right? It looks like something straight out of, like, Silent Hill. That's you. That's what you sound like. He's, like, made of corpses. He's a weird fucking boss. Ugly as sin. The Rotten. That's this guy's name. Yeah. All right, now, the Rotten is immune to fire, if I remember correctly, but I am not. So it's important to remember that when, you know, putting context down onto, like, stuff of that nature. It appears that Lone Hunter Schmidt is, at least he's trying. He's trying. He's, putting arrows into the guy. If Schmidt could get this fucker off of me, that'd be spectacular right now. I'll tell you that for free. The thing you gotta be careful about is that the Rotten has a tendency to knock you into fire. Man, Schmidt, you fucking suck, dude. I was already, like, almost dead. What the fuck? Ugh. I think the problem is that this boss has, like, no good time to, like, approach him and to get, like, hits in. Oh, well, this is gonna hurt. Please don't kill me. Ow! Oh! That's a ton of damage. If you just get him to, like, attack Schmidt a little bit, we'd be fucking golden. Oh! Well, don't be in the fire, please. You know what? Run away. Oh, I'm in the fire. Oh, I ran right into the fire. Right into the fire like a goddamned idiot. Well, that sucks. That sucks. We're gonna take another crack at him before I call it quits for this episode. Then I need to see what the file size for this episode was, and we gotta see if these settings are gonna work at all. I think they will. I think they're fine. But my biggest concern, as always, is the fact that, like... So my hard drive that I'm using is pretty good. It's a 1 terabyte hard drive, which is it's fairly big. The problem is that, if these file sizes are too big, like, I can't justify, like, using a file that big to, like, you know, make a recording. Like, if it was, like, I don't know, family photos or something, maybe we could talk about, like, some fucking file sizes in, like, the hundreds of gigabytes. And I do mean hundreds of gigabytes. Like, that's sort of, like, what these settings might do if I'm not careful. I'm already poisoned, yo. I'm glad these things don't do, like, actual damage to you. Oh, God, this is gonna be such a pain in the dick. Use your head to aim it. There you go. Blind stab using your head as an aiming tool. There you go. Right, I think all of those are broken now, which means that we should be able to summon stupid-ass dumb Schmidt. You know, I feel even less bad about summoning Schmidt now that I know he's a goddamn loser. Like, he's just bad. Like, he's not helpful. He's doing, like, 100 damage. Doesn't even pull aggro. What a dick. Alright, let's go ahead and get some distance from the rotten here. Perfect. Block that shit. I'll grab my souls in a second here. Oh, well. Alright, fine. Schmidt, get it together. Stay out of the fire. Blocked. Alright, we're doing fine. We're doing fine. I might have to go to rolling more often than not during this boss fight, to be honest. But, we'll see. I mean, I'm not terribly concerned. Schmidt, stop rolling around back there. Fucking hit the boss. That's what I paid you for. You don't actually pay the guys in Dark Souls. Just, want to make that very clear. God, this thing does no fucking damage anymore. We're starting to get to the point where, like, I need to start getting, like, a stat-scaling weapon upgraded. So that way I can have, like, I can do, like, 400, 300 damage to, like, bosses like this. So, we're starting to come up against it a little bit. Not terribly bad, but, you know, something to consider, basically. Just need to get, like, one or two hits in every time he gives me an opening, basically. Alright. I think I found the strategy here. The trick is to roll. Which is good, because I know how to roll. Because rolling is half the battle here. I just wish he would, like, get hurt by the fire, like... I feel like it should be a thing that he gets hurt by the fire. I can't believe I got hit by that. It was only a little bit, but I'm still upset about it. Alright, there we go. Block. Block, block, block. Why are you like this? Ow. Get up and drink. Stay away from the fire. We just gotta be, like, we gotta be cautious, because, like, I don't know this boss's patterns, like, at all. So, the problem is that I don't know, like, when my openings are gonna come. Ow, why is that a sweep instead of, like, another chop? It was a chop last time he did it. What a dick. Well, okay, that hurts badly. Drink, and then put up your shield immediately, because you're going to get chopped. Oh, god damn it. Oh, god damn it. Come on. Get it together. We're out of, fucking Estus. So pop a divine blessing, I guess. They really don't want you to use that in combat. That took 100 years for that animation to go off. You all saw it. You were there. Alright, easy does it. Just take it nice and slow. Try to get your hit glicks in when you can, basically. I managed to block that one, so I didn't take any damage. I got slammed on. Come on, a slam, and welcome to Japan and all that, you know. You know how it is in the biz. Yo. Oh! Pop a life gem. Pop a couple, actually. Let's pop like three. Well, two is gonna have to do, because I got a block. Oh, I'm in the fire. Oh, I'm in the fire. Oh, I'm not gonna be in the fire. Okay, I'm good. Woo, dog! I want that ring that, like, passively regenerates HP that's in Demon Souls. That was the best ring. Yeah, there's a ring in Demon Souls that, like, heals you for one tick of HP, like, every now and then. And it's, like, it's at a constant rate, don't get me wrong, but it's, like, not terribly often. Run. Go. Ugh, fucking burning my ass alive here. Where the hell do I go? There's a cave over there. There's a cave on my head. Don't call me a cave head. I did it! Yeah, that boss is a lot harder when you don't know that bonfire's there. Are you bad? No, you're not bad. You're an iron chest, and you're full of... Sublime Bone Dust. Fantastic. Great item to get. Super good way to close out the episode here, I guess. As a primal bonfire, and that is another one of the DLC fonts. Alright, so that makes two that we know where it is. I'm sorry, what? Hey, what up, yo? Oh. Yeah, sure, man.
Then accept defeat of your guilt and face the trials that await you.
Well, I've never seen this before.
And yes, you have already joined the quest for...
Yo, you wanna fight? I'll fucking stab your ass.
Young Hollow, there are but two paths. Inherit the order of this world, or destroy it.
This guy's looking to get stabbed, I'm telling you.
Very few indeed have come in this far. And yet your journey is far from over.
Oh, that's good. More episodes.
Have you what it takes? Truly?
I mean, yeah. Fucking stab your ass right now. You want to fight?
Young Hollow, he who almost. The Vendrick is certain to go. Fledgling Hollow.
Alright, let's fucking find Vendrick. Yeah, I don't remember that at all. Is that new? Because I don't remember that. I think I would remember a giant, horrible plant head man coming out of one of the primal bonfires, sticking his face in my business, trying to act like he knows me. Like, fucking, this guy, fucking jerkbag, that's what he is. Alright, but with that, because we got the final primal bonfire set up and good to go, I think we're going to call it quits for this episode. So thank you all so much for watching. If you like what you saw, let me know. If you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date. I'm going to post more videos. And if you really like what you saw, leave a like. It helps the channel grow, helps me out a great deal. And let me know about the quality of the videos. You know, how am I doing? How's it looking? How's all that stuff? It looks good on my end, but I want to know if you guys are enjoying it. So thank you all so much for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!